Hey, what's up everybody around the world? Welcome back to another tutorial in Revit Global Knowledge. Today I'm going to show you another interesting facade in Revit. Okay, so before I get started, I would like to ask you, and this is your first time reacting out to my channel or visiting to my channel, and make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for notification for learn more about Revit. Okay, so now let's speak into our project together. As you can see here, I am in architecture interface for template. I would like to create those kind of facade. Let me show you first. Okay, so this one is that facade that I want to create. It's a complex facade for concrete. And okay, sorry. We will create for this component using our adaptive component, adaptive family. As you can see over there, we got slope here, and here got another slope as well. And this one I will make some kind of 500 millimeter for offset, and for the slope for the slope down one, I want to make it for 200 millimeter, and for the high here, I will make it for kinda is, yeah, let's make this one for 100 millimeter, 4 meter for high for our component. And for here we will create tool family for flip here. Okay, if you want to know how to do that, follow from start to finish and make sure don't forget to hit subscribe actually. Okay, so now I want to speak back to my project first. I need to cancel first. Okay, so now as you can see, I am architecture template again, so I can go to my file here and go to new. Okay, sorry, go to file, go to new and go to family and go to English. We're using for adaptive component, generate model adaptive, where is it? Okay, this guy over there, then I can open. Okay, so now as you can see, I am rig adaptive component interface, but normally you can draw any set because adaptive component will be flexible on our shape there. It depends how you place that and how many points you want to place. But in my case there, I want a specific for size, so I will make kind of some old reference plan only I load into my project because I want a specific dimension for my facade here. Okay, so I can go from top here, then I can go to place plan, then use a pick. Then offset this one for 250 millimeter here as well, and for the horizon, let's say this guy here is a vertical for 4 meter. Okay, just make it for 2 meter. One and two, hit escape. Okay, so now what I'm going to do next, I'm going to place my adaptive point here. By place that, I need to go to my reference and point, draw on first. Okay, in my case here, I will draw on work plan. Then I can draw here 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then hit escape. I just select all my point here and make adaptive here. Go to reference again, plus another point. I will start plus from this guy over there. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Then I can escape. What I'm going to do next, I will make a parametric for offset because I want to make a two tie of my component here. So I can zoom a nearer a bit, then hit a tab key on my keyboard, select one, and another guy here, hit a tab key again, hit control key for multiple selection. Then take a look on my property here, got offset here. I can assign for new parameter, create new, then make this one for top point. Okay, cap here, Control C, then I can hit OK. It's OK again. Go to the bottom one, hit a tab key, and this guy, hit a tab key again until I got my point here. Okay, hit Control key, assign a new offset parameter, create new, Control V for press, change this one to bottom. Okay, hit OK, then I can hit finish. Let's go to our family tie here, then I can offset for, let's say, okay, for the top point here, I want to make it 500 millimeter as I showed you before, and this guy over there make it for 200 millimeter, then I can hit apply, then I can finish. What I'm going to do next is I'm going to use a reference line to connect that, and after that only I start create form. Go to my reference here, select line, draw on first, make sure you turn on for 3D snapping, then I can start from the bottom 1 and 2 and 3 and 2 and go to 1 again, hit escape, go to another guy here, 4 here, here, go to 3 and go to 4, and I can hit escape, and I can select all my reference here and go to create form, select form, solid form, use a flat one, and this guy here. Okay, and create form, solid form, flat one, select my component here, hit a tab key until it got like this, and go to another guy here, hit a control key again for multiple selection, create and create solid form. As you can see, now I got my first component here, but we want to make two component about that, but we don't need to create repeat that, just go to my family tie, then go to create tab here, tie one, and create this one for tie two. For tie two, we just pick for our dimension here, offset here, make this one for 500 and make this guy for 200, then I can hit apply. As you can see, okay, perfect. Let's go to our photo there. See, as you can see, here is my first component and this guy is my second component, so they will speak together as well. So I can go back to my family again, but I want to sell first, sell file, and make this one on desktop. Let's say we give a name for my tutorial is 55 and ADA Adaptio family. I will put link in the description for those family component if you want to use that for testing. Then I can hit open. Okay, okay, go to desktop here, sorry, then I can sell that. Okay, perfect. So I'm going to my, I just go back to my architecture template here. So you got two way to create your meshing. One, you go to your meshing inside, then use your meshing here. And another one, you just go to your architecture tab and go to component and go to model in place. Then go to, where is my mesh here? Okay, here, and I can hit OK. Just give a name for mask 1. I can simply create rectangle like this. Hit escape. Open up for 3D default. Okay, so I just like all my rectangle here. Create form, solid form, like this. And I want to make it higher a bit, make it for 16 meter. Okay, sorry. Yep. And for width here, make it for just make it for 4 meter. Okay, perfect. So what I'm going to do next, I will divide surface just like my surface here. Then go to divide surface. Make this one is a specific size from our component, and this fridge stand, make this guy for 4 meter, and this guy over there make it for fridge stand, make it for 500 millimeter. Then I can apply, then I can load my family here, go to 3D and I can load in, go to my 3D again. Okay, so now we can place our component, but it's too crazy because we just can snap only one point. But don't worry about that, just escape first, select my surface here, go to surface representation and just turn on for node here, then you can hit OK. Now your node is show up, so easier for us to place our component. I can go to create tab component, then I can start simply place here 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, hit escape, then start place here 1 2 3 and 4. Perfect. Another guy there, 1 2 3 4, 1 2 3 4, hit escape first, hit escape first. Okay, let's see this one, I need to rotate that, so just select here, then turn it on for family 2, will be flip. Okay, so now let's see our facade here. Okay, this one we need to flip as well, so I can turn back to my 3D again, go to create, go to component, 1 2 3 and 4, 1 2 3 and 4. The last guy over there, hit escape. Now I want to flip that to tie 2. See everything, is it everything is perfect? Switch this one for tie 2 as well. Okay, yes, so now we got our point as you can see, but it's too crazy if we are just plus 1 by 1, but anyway don't worry about that, we got we know how to show that. I just select here 1 and 2 and 3 4 5 6 7 8, then take a look on repeat here, you just like repeat, so will be automatic repeat all as you can see. Okay, let's make Ctrl Z, but first I think we not select all. I select here 1 and 2. Make sure everything is selection. Okay, as you can see, this guy over there is wrong. That's why our when we repeat is not normal. So I can delete this guy first. Okay, just make sure everything is correct position. And this guy I can hide element first, easier for me. Okay, go to create, go to component, let's see 1 2 3 4, hit escape. Let me turn on first. Here I want to flip. Okay, yeah, I think now our component is perfect, just like here 1, 2, 3, and 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then I can go to repeat tab, Okay, as you can see, and you can add a lot of a lot of components from here until let's say this one just let me see this here from here to here just a 4 meter, but you can add a lot from here to here from more component, as you can see, and it's running properly. Okay guys, so I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. I hope you got learned something new from that, and make sure let me hit finish first. As you can see, let me preview first. Our facade is running properly, same as our picture there. It's a concrete, but if you want to apply for reinforcement for this kind of facade, you might be need to select all, then turn on for structure and use a freeform rebar, easier and faster to create those kind of shape. Just my suggestion. And okay guys, I think it's pretty much for this tutorial. Thank you guys for joining me from start to finish, and make sure hit subscribe button below and turn on for notification for learn more about Revit so you won't miss anything for my future tutorial. And also take a look on the end card, see what I want to suggestion for watching my tutorial. Thank you guys for watching from start to finish, and I see you for another tutorial, and have a nice day. Thank you.